Good morning, friends. I am Ashish Agarwal from Team NGO Enabler, and today I will discuss on one of the most important and awaited topic: how to download Form 10AC, that is the new certificates under Section 12AB and 80G from the new income tax portal. Giving you the background very briefly, the process of filing Form 10A on the income tax portal for renewal of registrations under Section 12AA, 12A and 1023C and 80G, or taking fresh registration under the new provisions, that is under Section 12AB and 80G with effect from 1st April 2021, started on the same date. The forms were getting filed smoothly up till 31st May 2021. However, due to the launch of the new portal on 7th June 2021 and several technical issues which persisted for months, the filing of Form 10A resumed only after 22nd July 2021. Few days later, the concerns started pouring in from various NGOs across the country that the ones who have applied on the old income tax portal were unable to download the certificate. At that time, for few days, even those who applied on the new portal was also not able to download it, but later the download was enabled for them. I would like to inform the viewers that recently the tab Download Form 10AC has been enabled even for those organizations who have applied on the old income tax portal. So let's check how you can download the new certificates from the new income tax portal. First, you need to log on to the new income tax portal, which is www.incometax.gov.in, by clicking on the login option. You will then be prompted to provide the user ID, which is the PAN of the organization. As soon as you fill the PAN, you can see that the tab Continue becomes active, and then you are asked to provide the password. But along with providing the user ID and password on the new portal, an additional security option has been auto activated, which is a secure access message. Currently, the default secure access message created is login, which can be changed by updating the profile after you log in to your income tax portal. So you need to click for confirming the secure access message, and only then you will be able to complete the login process. Once you log in, you will be prompted to a kind of home page of your income tax portal, where either you can update your profile or skip it for the time being. So as of now, let's click on skip. Now this is how the dashboard looks, which was mentioned as one of the features of the new income tax portal. Here you need to move to the e-file tab and select the option income tax form, then view e-filed forms. Once you click on it, you will find the tabs related to all the forms filed by you till date, out of which one of the tabs will be of Form 10A. So you need to move to the tab Form 10A and click on View All. You will then be directed to the screen where all the details related to the filing of Form 10A is available. Here, check the right panel where the options for downloading Form 10A, its receipt, and finally the Form 10AC, that is the certificate under the new provisions, is available. As soon as you click on the option Download Form 10AC, the certificate gets downloaded. Now let's decode and understand the certificate itself. You can see that the certificate starts with PAN, followed by the name and complete address of the organization. In point number 5, you will find the provisional registration number, followed by the section under which the registration is granted and the date of registration. In point number 8, the period for which the registration is granted has been mentioned. In case of new registrations, you will find that the validity is up to 3 assessment years. And in case of renewal of existing registrations, the validity shall be for 5 years. On plain reading of the amendment, it was understood that provisional registrations shall be granted only to new organizations for a period of 3 years, and for existing organizations, permanent registration shall be granted with a validity of 5 years. But here we can see, even in renewal cases, order for provisional registration is being passed. Why so? In our view, it seems that the intention of using the word provisional was misunderstood and misinterpreted. Since this time the renewal is being granted without any verification or investigation of documents, as no powers to call for any documents were conferred upon the concerned authorities as per the provisions laid down in the amended act, the word provisional is being used even in such cases. Here we are also of the opinion that at the time of second renewal, since the documents might be called for and proper verification might be conducted before renewing the registration again for a period of 5 years, permanent registration word might be used at that time while passing the order. But nothing could be outrightly said regarding this as of now. Coming to the last part of the order, certain conditions have been laid out subject to which such provisional registration is being granted, and failure to comply with the same might lead to cancellation or suspension of such registration. Out of the 18 conditions, the major ones from which the intention of the legislation shall clearly come out is being discussed in this video. Firstly, any changes or alteration in the objects and regulations of the applicant shall require prior approval of the Commissioner of Income Tax. Next, in the event of dissolution, the surplus and the assets shall be transferred to any other charitable organization with similar objectives and shall not be distributed among the members or anybody specified in Section 13(3) of the Income Tax Act. Then comes the registration under Section 12AB does not confer any rights on the donor to claim deduction under Section 80G, because for that the organization must be registered under Section 80G of the Income Tax Act. Next, the organization need to maintain the accounts regularly and get it audited in accordance with the provisions of Section 12A. Subsection 1 clause B of the Income Tax Act. The income tax return shall be furnished by the organization within the prescribed time limit. Next comes that the registered office or the principal place of the activity shall not be shifted outside the jurisdiction of the jurisdictional commissioner of income tax without prior approval. The last condition which we are going to discuss today is any incorrect or false information, if found later, might lead to cancellation of the registration. This implies that the organizations should fill Form 10A very carefully and provide correct and true information. Just because the registration is being granted instantly without calling for any documents, no shortcuts should be used. Now, one of the conditions related to transfer of assets need more clarification in our opinion. The condition says that no asset shall be transferred without the knowledge of jurisdictional commissioner of income tax to anyone, including any trust, society, section 8 company, etc. Does that mean that no assets can now be sold by the organization at all without intimating the commissioner? Will it be practically feasible to intimate each time the organization is disposing or transferring any asset to any individual or other charitable organization? Was this the intent of the law? Sometimes, due to scrap or in exchange of new asset, the old assets are sold or transferred. Will the organization really need to intimate about this petty transaction every time to the Commissioner of Income Tax? Anyways, the mode and the reason for intimation has not been detailed yet anywhere in the Act or the certificate, but in our view, it's high time CBDT or the Ministry comes up with a clarification on the same, else it will really be a harassment for the charitable organizations and increase the paperwork considerably without any valid, proper and logical reasoning. So this was all about downloading and understanding Form 10AC on the new income tax portal. For further details, you can visit our website and keep tuned to our channel. For any queries, feel free to comment below or contact us through email. Thank you.